I make sure my people good, I can't do nothing for free. Why the fuck would I stop now? They depending on me. Niggas ain't they never seen me, they just heard me. What's up, y'all? So I'm finally back on the channel with it. I know it's been like a little minute, but honestly, I'm not even gonna fake with y'all or give no excuses. You know, sometimes life can just get in the way of shit. You feel me? Like, life just gets in the way sometimes, and we gotta take a little step back, take a little break to get some things right, and then, you know, continue to keep pushing forward. So that's exactly what I'm doing. I'm back on here for y'all. You know, I'm not going anywhere for sure. No matter what, I'm not going nowhere. I'm not going nowhere no time soon. I'm always post on the YouTube and TikTok and Instagram. Like, if I'm not posting on YouTube, you can definitely catch me on Instagram posting a reel or something. Like, I'll never just leave y'all hanging like that. You feel me? But today, basically, I'm going to do like a little, you know, I'm going to catch y'all up a little bit, like a little life update. Basically, I posted on my Instagram Q&A type shit. So I'm going to answer some questions for y'all, update y'all. And I'm going to also be, I have some people that ask me questions about hair, like hair stuff. So I'm going to be trying a new hair product too. It's Miss Jessie's Pillow Curls. I usually use Mielle, but I'm going to try something different because I want my hair to come out like more softer. So I'm going to take a shower, wash it, put that on it, and then I'm going to come back to y'all.
All right, y'all, so got the setup right, and now we're finna get straight into the questions. So the first question is, what's my goals for this year, 2024? And honestly, it's really like all the goals that I didn't complete last year is kind of just the same things I'm trying to get done, which is to have, number one is have better money management. I feel like I could be handling my money way better, so I just want to keep working and growing my savings. And number two is to just put more and push myself more into, you know, the things that I'm trying to do, like content wise with like YouTube and Instagram. Like, just keep doing what I'm doing now, just finding my lane and really, like, you know, putting myself out there more and just growing myself as eventually one day into like my own brand. You feel me? Like Brazil Armani, that's gonna be my own brand. That's gonna be me. I want to be like more known and, you know, just collab with more people as well. That was also a question on there, is if I'm gonna start collabing with people. And yes, I'm gonna start collabing with more people whenever like the opportunity presents itself, and just keep trying to get myself out there more and, you know, keep going and stay consistent. I'm back with it, you feel me? Cup of teleport. So the next question is, what is your type? I feel like I always say the same stuff. So my type is basically just a pretty black female. You know, that's my preferred race. And like somebody that I can just, you know, have good conversation with, you know, talk like somebody with the somewhat of the same interests, you know, smart, gotta have a head on straight, gotta have something going for themselves, gotta have a little ass. I'm not even gonna lie to you. And yeah, just an overall good person. That's my type. So the next question is, do I plan my fits out before I post them on Instagram? And the question is, yes, I do plan my fits out. Like if I'm making, for example, my reels or something, I'm definitely gonna plan it out, because it's most likely brands, like small clothing brands, sending me clothes and stuff. So I already know like what kind of reel I'm gonna be making based off what they send me. So I just plan around whatever pieces they send me, whether it be like a shirt, a jacket, or anything like that. But yeah, anything that's posted on the gram is definitely planned, because, you know, I'm real particular. I want to look good on that, so I'll be planning shit. And then another question was, this off top because I just read it, are you gonna like collab with more clothing brands? Because I did that one photo shoot for a streetwear brand, We Are All Misunderstood. Make sure y'all go shop with them. I got them tagged on my IG on my pictures. And yes, I definitely am. That's like one of, I'm getting more into like the, I'm just slowly figuring out like my interests and certain things I really want to like pour into. And clothes is one of those things, because like I started posting the reels and y'all see like how many views they're getting. That shit just like turned me up even more to make me want to just like keep going in that direction. So if another opportunity presents itself to like work with a clothing brand, so and so, this and that, I'm definitely gonna take it. And eventually one day, like, it's just a thought in the back of my head, like when I get to like where I want to go, like as far as like stamping myself with YouTube and I'm just like, you know, trying to dip my hand into different things, I definitely want to eventually start my own clothing brand, you know, because I really do love clothes. I love putting together fits. It's just like, it's a fun process. So my own clothing brand would be like a dream one day to finally kick up and start. So the next question is, what was my worst sexual experience? My worst sexual experience, let me see. I'm going to try to keep this real, real discreet, like real, real discreet. But I think, all right, yeah. It was my first time using a strap, right? And it was this with somebody that I was dealing with at the time, but it was our first time bringing a strap into play. So, you know, you know what you got to do to get in that mood. So when you're in that mood, then I pulled, you know what I'm saying? Pulled the strap off, and you know, I had her legs up, Should I keep this shit PG? A smell just like arose up into my nose, bro. I kid you not, like, we right in the middle of finna doing something, and a smell just rose up, bro. And in my head, it's like, what do you do in this situation? Like, bro, what am I supposed to do in this situation? Am I supposed to say something? Am I supposed to keep going? Like, what am I supposed to do in this situation? So in the smell, I'm not even going to try to describe the smell because I don't want to be disrespectful. I'm not trying to be come off like that, but I'm just being real. Like, it just rose up and I was like, and then she wanted me to eat it too. And I was like, I finessed my way out of doing that because heck no. But you got to see it through sometime, you know. It was one of my first experiences, so I had to see it through. I'm not proud of that, but I just had to see it through, fam. Like, I had to see it through. But that was like my worst sexual experience, and I wouldn't even say it was the worst. Like, it was just like the smell just threw me off. So it was just like something that I wasn't gonna double back on. So yeah, that's probably the worst sexual experience. The next question is, have I ever been in love before? This is kind of a good question. It's kind of a good love question. We getting into it for sure. But I say I've been in love one good time, because I've been in two relationships. The first one, I wouldn't say it was really love. It was just love for, like, you know how people be saying, love for what you knew it to be at the moment. First relationship, you testing the waters. You still trying to figure out yourself and stuff like that. So I wouldn't really count that as being in love. But the second one, I was in love for the second relationship. It was cool for, you know, the moment and shit like that. But yeah, I've been. All right, so the next question is, what's some things I can't live without? And I brought some things right there, so I'm gonna show y'all. These are some things that I cannot live without. Can't live without my wallet. Like, this is my ID, my money, everything is in my wallet, my cards, my fucking insurance, everything is in my wallet. I can't. Thing is, gum. Gotta have this on me 24/7. Can't leave the house without some type of gum in my pocket. Most important thing is my headphones. And yes, I have wired headphones because they sound way louder than AirPods, way louder than Beats. Like, nothing is louder than these headphones. And if you think something is louder than these headphones, please drop it in the comments, because these wires are undefeated. I listen to music 24/7. All times of the day, I just gotta have music, bro. I cannot live without music. But smell goods. I cannot leave a house without smelling good. That's like, this is a big essential right here. And if y'all wanna know what I be putting on, let me know in the comments and I'll put y'all on too. Can't live without shoes. These are like, I literally can't live without a good pair of sneakers. Like, I need some Jordans. Jordans to be specific. I cannot live without Jordans, bro. I need Jordans on my feet. Next question is, y'all was trolling on the question thing, bro. Like, y'all funny as fuck. But the next question is my first time giving head. And I'm not trying to be so explicit on here, but y'all asked, so I'm gonna answer. So, my first time giving head, bro, how old was I? Because I didn't really start doing, I didn't start getting like sexually active until I graduated high school. So I was probably like 17, 18 when I did that for the first time. And the girl, she was real cool about it. She was really cool about it. I had let her know, like, you know, this is gonna be like my first time doing something like this. And she was like, bet, it's cool, whatever, whatever, whatever. So I went over there, we vibing. You already know. You know what it is when you go over a little girl house and stuff, where y'all already know what the vibes be. I went over there, probably looking good, smelling good. You know, I'm ready for the occasion of what's gonna take place. So one thing led to another. It's time to eat. Like, you feel me? Like, it's time to eat, bruh. So I got down there and I was just doing like my own little thing, figuring out. And then she was like, she told me to, I forgot what way she told me to do something, but she told me to do something like a certain way down there with my mouth, obviously. And after I did that, it was like, it was easy. Like, everything just came to me. I feel like girls, we know what we like and we know how we want to be pleasure. So it should come real easy to you. Like, if you're a lesbian and you still don't know what you're doing down there, and you know what I'm saying, I really don't know what to say. You can't be a lesbian for real, because I feel like girls, we have the advantage. So we have the, I mean, like, saying we got the advantage over guys, because we know exactly what to do, we know where it's at, we know what I'm talking about. But yeah, my experience with that was just smooth. All right, so the last question is, do you feel the best version of yourself since you switched to a stud? And the answer is, that was a really good question, by the way. The answer is yes. I feel like I'm finally just myself. I feel like I'm finally truly me, and I'm doing what makes me happy and being a person that makes me happy. So yes, I do feel like my best. I feel like the best version of myself, like, right now, as in since, like, me, since I first transitioned to a stud till now, like, I feel like me now in this exact present moment is the best version of myself so far. And, you know, I can't wait to continue to grow and to see, like, the woman that I'm gonna be, because, you know I got my head on straight for sure. I'm not perfect, but I feel like I'm on the right track to, you know, being the person that I truly want to be. So I hope I can, you know, continue to take y'all on this crazy ass journey we call life with me. You know, appreciate y'all for supporting me, you know, watching my videos. Appreciate everybody who reached out to me and, you know, sends me like little compliments and stuff, like, on the content that I do, because I read all my DMs and requests and I see it. So I just want to thank y'all for, like, continuously supporting me. Like, that's the shit that keeps me going. It reassures me that, you know, I'm doing what I'm supposed to do, and hopefully, you know, I'm walking in my purpose. So yeah, basically the end of the video, y'all, don't worry, I'm not gonna go ghost like that for no whole ass other month. I'm back on it, you feel me? I'm not going nowhere. Y'all stay tuned. I got way more videos coming. I'm gonna catch y'all in the next one.